Yeah, this time we'll definitely cover HDR videos. But more importantly, I'm making this video because a lot of you did not watch the part one from start to end. Here's part one in case you didn't watch it yet. So at least this time, please don't skip any part. I saw a lot of negative comments, some of them genuine criticism. Thank you for that. Some of them just yelling from Redmi fanboys. Some of them just keyboard warriors. Let me address the Redmi fanboys first. Guys, you didn't watch the full video. In the conclusion part, I literally said the Redmi Note 10 Pro Max still probably has the best and the brightest display under 20,000 rupees. What part of that makes me a Redmi hater? In case I say a smartphone display is bad, it doesn't mean I hate that brand. It just means the display is bad. As simple as that. Next up, let me address those who doubted the process, who doubted my research. Now, of course, I'm not someone who says I'm right 100% of the time. You know me. We all tend to make mistakes, but there are certain things some of you misunderstood or did not verify properly. So I'll show some of those comments and reply to them one after another. Number one, you should have switched off all the lights in the room. Only then the measurement will be accurate. So I get where you're coming from. You're worried about all those lights above me reaching the sensor. But actually, they don't. When you firmly hold it against the screen, it's completely sealed and there is no light leak whatsoever. Anyway, we'll try it out. Lights on. Switching off a few lights. Switching off all the lights now. The reading is the same, as you can see here. Number two, there is a sunlight mode on Redmi phones. You need to enable that in order to achieve peak brightness. Well, not really. Sunlight mode on Redmi phones is required only when auto brightness is disabled. But in the previous video, we did the outdoor test with auto brightness enabled. You can verify this yourself in settings. Here it clearly says adjust auto brightness to strong ambient light when automatic brightness is off. So let's move on to number three. Dude, nits is equal to lux into 3.14, lux into pi. So your readings are completely wrong. Well, while doing the research, I also happened to come across the same formula, but that's incorrect, at least in this setting. Just think, in the previous video, when we took the phones to the terrace and measured the brightness, these were the readings. Now multiply them by 3.14. The answer is more than 3,500 nits for the OnePlus 8 Pro and around 3,000 nits for the Note 10 Pro Max, which are obviously incorrect. So, number four, and that's the final one, and it's gonna take a while. Why didn't you play an HDR video? Why don't you know the display hits peak brightness levels only when you play HDR videos? Well, you're right. I'll tell you why I didn't do it. But let's first get the readings with HDR content on the screen. There is a dedicated HDR video on YouTube specifically for brightness measurement. I'll leave the link to this video in the description. OnePlus 8 Pro, almost 1400 lux. Note 10 Pro Max, almost 1200. Realme 8 Pro, 940. OnePlus Nord, around 1150. So you may notice that both the OnePlus phones crossed whatever brightness levels OnePlus claimed. The Note 10 Pro Max has equaled Redmi's claim of 1200, while the Realme 8 Pro didn't go anywhere close to Realme's claim of 1000. The thing is, only around 10% of the display was used by this frame. So 90% of the screen is actually turned off. So in these specific conditions, the Redmi Note 10 Pro Max reaches whatever peak brightness levels Redmi claims. OnePlus's numbers went way beyond their claim of 1300 nits because they probably used a different method to achieve 1300. Like, they probably had 40% of the display turned on instead of just 10%. I really don't know what exactly happens behind the scenes, but what I do know is that different brands use different methods. They measure brightness in different conditions. Now, you know what? Of course, I knew the Note 10 Pro Max reaches 1200 nits under some conditions. That's why they claim 1200. I didn't want to verify it in the previous video because I trust Redmi. I trust almost every brand for that matter. They cannot make such a claim unless the display actually reaches that level. But how they manage to achieve it, you know, it differs from brand to brand, and that's where the problem is. So then why did I make this video or the previous display scam video? What was my motive? What did I want to convey? listen very carefully. I just wanted to measure the brightness of a few phones in a few different scenarios to see how the Note 10 Pro Max fared against some other phones. Basically, when someone looks at the specifications, when they see 1200 nits, I don't want them to think, wow, that's very close to flagship displays. That's it, as simple as that. Because it's not very close to flagship level displays. Yes, somehow brands manage to achieve a very high number, peak brightness, but you probably won't use the phone in such a scenario very often. We need to know whether it's proportionally good even when we play other contents in other conditions. The same goes to the other phones. While playing HDR video, the OnePlus Nord was brighter than the Realme 8 Pro, but in the previous video, almost in every scenario, the Realme 8 Pro was brighter than the Nord. So, for the nth time, I'm telling you, these numbers shouldn't be taken seriously. What really matters is how bright these phones can get in various different scenarios. And as you can see, the Note 10 Pro Max is not very close to the OnePlus 8 Pro. So these numbers are generally quite skewed. So what matters is not these numbers, but how they compare to other phones. So that's the reason I included three other phones from different price segments. Realme 8 Pro under 20,000, OnePlus Nord under 30,000, and OnePlus 8 Pro above 50,000. On paper, these are the numbers claimed by the brands, and I just wanted to check if these numbers are proportional across all types of content in you know, real conditions like this. Now, this is another HDR video I played on the Note 10 Pro Max and OnePlus 8 Pro. These were the readings, 120 nits and 97 nits. Not very close, right? And in the previous video, it's not like I didn't play HDR video on the Note 10 Pro Max alone. I didn't play HDR video on the OnePlus 8 Pro either. So how could that phone go up to 1250 plus nits, but the Note 10 Pro Max couldn't go past 900? I mean, I'm not blaming this or anything. Like I said, like I already said multiple times, this is the best display you can get under 20,000 rupees today. No doubts about that. And believe it or not, there is a bunch of people who buy this phone expecting to see flagship level quality or brightness, and then they end up cribbing about it. But truth is, it has the best display under 20,000 rupees, probably even 25 or 30,000 rupees. So, numbers are sometimes just numbers. Don't just blindly go by what the brands claim. So Ashwin, if we cannot judge a display's brightness by the peak brightness levels claimed by brands, how else do we judge it? Well, unfortunately, there is no way to know through the spec sheet. Just like how you cannot judge a phone's performance by benchmarks or specs, because there is much more to it, right? But there is something called APL. Not gonna bore you with the explanation, but I'll just tell you what its impact is. Basically, higher APL means display cannot get very bright. Lower APL, brightness can shoot up. So for example, if you measure the OnePlus 8 Pro's brightness at 100% APL, let's say you get 1300 nits, just for example. But if you measure at 50% APL, it might go to 1400 or even 1450. You get it, lower the APL, higher the brightness can be. The problem is, different brands use different APLs under different conditions to measure the brightness. So there must be some kind of standard that all brands should follow to measure the brightness. Or at least brands should mention at what APL they got the claimed brightness levels. That way we'll have some idea, right? So, before I sign off, another important message. If you guys need my unbiased, honest opinion, you guys need to let me share it. Trust me, I usually put in a ton of effort into research and script. If you've been a subscriber, you probably know about such detailed explanation videos. The basic camera terms video, you can watch it here. I'm pretty sure you already know about it. And then the laptop buying guide video, in which I didn't just name five laptops and asked you to buy one of them, but instead taught you how to pick a laptop according to your needs and your budget. Again, link. Despite all the research and effort, there is definitely a chance I make a mistake here and there, and you should definitely point it out and let me know. I don't want my channel to have any misleading information, but abusing in the comment section, calling me names, calling me a paid YouTuber or a hater of a brand or a fanboy of a brand, That's a bit of a stretch, and if I were you, I would avoid it. This applies to all YouTube channels, not just mine. That's all I'm saying. Thanks for hearing me out. Peace.